लेट अस से आउट ऑफ 100 इज ए ज्वाइन, इवन वन इज गेट्स मोटिवेटेड इज योर सक्सेस।
यस सर, सर बट दिस इज ए AICTE प्रोग्राम, सो दे
डजेंट
अलाउ
मैटर,
ओनली, दे
नो
अलाउ
नो
ओनली
नो,
रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स एंड फैकल्टी
सी
मेंबर्स फॉर दिस
इफ यू
प्रोग्राम.
सेंड लिंक टू अनदर 5 स्टूडेंट, डू यू थिंक AICTE विल चार्ज यू फॉर दैट?
नो सर, दे आर नॉट चार्जिंग
देन
एनीथिंग.
यू शुड टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस फैसिलिटी देन।
सर एक्चुअली वी हैव रिकॉर्डेड ऑल द सेशंस एंड सून वी आर अपलोडिंग ऑन द आवर AKGC यूट्यूब चैनल।
Sir, that is very fine, but listening directly from the horse's mouth is much more beneficial. Anyway, but recording itself is going to serve some purpose.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, Dr. Devendra Singh here.
Yes, how are you, sir?
सर आई एम फाइन सर, आप कैसे हैं सर?
एकदम बढ़िया, देख के अच्छा लग रहा है आपको।
सर सर इट इज माय प्लेजर सर टू हैव यू विद अस सर।
सेम है सर, एक आसे ताली कभी नहीं बजती।
सो नाउ आई थिंक डॉक्टर नंबर था, वी मे स्टार्ट। प्रोफेसर पल्लव।
यस सर, यस सर,
निर्मल
निर्मल
निर्मल निर्मल प्लीज।
ओके सर, ओके, थैंक यू। जय हिंद। Very good afternoon to everyone. On behalf of Department of Mechanical Engineering, Ajay Kumar Engineering College, Ghaziabad, I, Nirmal Garg, Assistant Professor of Mechanical Engineering, welcome you all for this valedictory session of this FDP. This is the AICTE-sponsored one-week faculty development program on novel material under ATAL scheme organized by Department of Mechanical Engineering, AKGC. We have successfully completed 14 sessions in 5 days of this FDP. Now we have reached the last session, that is validatory session, and will be concluding this FDP. I hope all of you had an informative time with our learned speakers. We will uploading all these recorded video of all the sessions soon in our AKGC YouTube channel. Now I would like to take the privilege to welcome our respected HOD sir, Dr. Devan Singh, the convener and coordinator of this ATAL FDP, to share his thoughts and kindly welcome our chief guest, Professor Sunil Pandey sir, and introduce him in few words. Okay. Over to you, sir.
Thanks, Nirmal.
Thank you.
It is my proud privilege to introduce our chief guest, Professor Sunil Pandey. He did his BE in mechanical engineering. I'm taking production engineering and PhD in welding. And he is working as the professor at JNU. Earlier, he has served the IIT. Delhi as a professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. Sir has served as Vice Chancellor and Director former for Sant Longwal Institute of Engineering Technology, SLIET, Deemed University CFTI under MHRD, Government of India, Longwal District, Sangrur, Punjab. Officiating head, Department of Production Engineering at Delhi College of Engineering, now Delhi Technological University. He has started his career with assistant professor, and he has done as assistant professor and head at Central Workshop at Delhi College of Engineering. Sir has a recipient of Heat Teacher Best Teacher Award by the Indian Institute of Technology Delhi in 2012. Sir has received Distinguished Alumnus Award by NITK Kurukshetra Engineering College.
Not Kurukshetra, it is Suratkar.
It is Suratkar, sir.
NIT Suratkar, NIT Karnataka.
NIT Karnataka, sir. Alma mater during the Diamond Jubilee year celebration in 2018. Lifetime, sir has received Lifetime Achievement Award by the Indian Welding Society for his contribution in the field of welding technology and research on 5th October 2016 in Mumbai. Sir has received a letter of commendation for his PhD thesis by the external examiner, Professor R.L. Apps of Cranfield Institute of Technology, Cranfield, England, with a statement, his PhD thesis was one of the best that I have examined in India or elsewhere, and he also has a marked aptitude for mechanical equipment, which makes him an asset in any laboratory. He has contributed to external agencies, like he has served as selection committee member, board member, academic council member, curriculum committee expert, research committee members, and numerous other activities, services. and he has he is member of professional societies like Life Fellow, Indian Institute of Welding, Life Fellow, Indian Welding Society, Life Member, Indian Society of Mechanical Engineers, Life Member, Indian Society of Technical Education, Life Member, Indian Society of Non-Destructive Testing, Member, ASM International. The title of his PhD is Some Studies on MID Welding of Aluminum and its Alloy 5083. The achievements and significant contribution during his PhD may be read as Professor R.L. Epps of Canfield Institute of Technology, UK, was the foreign examiner for the thesis, and he issued a testimonial stating his PhD thesis was one of the best that he had examined in India or elsewhere, and he also has a marked aptitude. He has mentioned that Professor Pandey has a marked aptitude for mechanical equipment, which makes him an asset in a laboratory. Sir has served several professional, academic, and administrative positions. Sir has combined professional experience for more than 45 years for these positions. Worked with the industry of academia in various capacities during this period. Sir has launched professional career of teaching and research with the Delhi Technological University, formerly Delhi College of Engineering, on 5th January 1987. Moved to the Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi on 18th May 1993 and superannuated as professor on 31st August 2018. Currently working as professor of mechanical engineering at Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. Served as the Sant Longowal Institute of Engineering Technology, Deemed University CFTI under the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, in the capacity of Vice Chancellor cum Director. SLIET was ranked 42nd amongst all engineering institutes in the country, including IITs, NITs, IISERs, IITs, etc., during 2014-15, and it enjoyed AAA rating, that is 4x A rating, when I was when sir was serving as Vice Chancellor cum Director. Source Career 360 started the Central School from class 1st to class 12 in project mode in SLIT. He has introduced 4 years Bachelor of Technology degree program. Sir has innovated in academics continuously. He is the inventor of seamless, most flexible multi-entry and multi-exit system of technical education. Sir has experienced zero complaint evaluation system, has developed the zero complaint evaluation system with brainstorming and academic speciality, leading to innovative research, industrial consultancy, patenting, and a possibility of startups. Sir have introduced the most flexible multi-entry and multi-exit system for technical education in SLIET during his vice chancellorship. Remaining two concepts are practiced for the last 20 years. Sir has innovative technology development patents in his cadet. Process and hardware protected by patent and patent application 6. Design registrations in his cadet 6. Product developments 3. Copyright 2. And technological development and established but didn't file patent application, it is 4. Innovative research and have invented 9 welding processes. Designed and developed hardware for 3 different welding processes. Designed and developed different types of welding electrodes and fluxes, including development of underwater welding electrodes. Developed 3 new and revolutionary welding technologies. These inventions are covered by patent and design registrations. Infrastructures have developed at IIT Delhi and at JNU. Sir has a very vast experience in the academics and research. Sir has guided 25 PhDs, and sir has guided 4 courses. Sir has taken the PG courses 4, UG courses 16. Sir has taught UG PG projects. Number of UG and PG projects have been guided by Professor Pandey. International journals. Sir has written 50 research papers, National Journal 8, keynote. Sir has sir has attended other one more than 150 seminar conference and as a keynote speaker. Yeah. International consultancy. Sir has
sir mera mera kaam mushkil kar rahe hain aap.
sir we are honored to have you with us, sir. We will be having benefit from your learned experience, sir. Now I request you, sir. Now I request Professor Pallab Biswas to welcome, sir, by presenting a sapling in virtual mode. Professor Pallab.
Sir, you are muted. Sir, you are muted.
Professor Pallab.
Thank you, sir, so much, sir. It is an honor, sir, to welcome you. I have seen you in IIT Delhi. This is for you. And we have actually planned to give something green which will grow with us. So we'll be delivering this to your home. Whenever we get time, I'll discuss with you and I'll send it to you.
Sir, thank you very much.
Thank you so kind much. Of you. For you, sir. Thank you, sir.
And presenting with the sapling is means you are supporting the sustainable environment also for the next generation.
Exactly.
Thank you. It's a great effort by you.
Thank you so much, sir.
And I receive it, and it has already come to my table in virtual mode.
Excellent.
So,
thank you, Professor Pallab.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir. Now I request our chief guest, Professor Sunil Pandey, sir, to please share his thoughts and enlightened her with this word of wisdom, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank
you. I'm sorry, actually, sir, I interrupted you in between because, you know, the more you introduce, the more you say about a person, the expectations of the audience, they increase proportionately. So you are making my job real tough because expectations go high. So that's why I'm sorry for interrupting you. They have given a very detailed description of my professional horoscope to the audience sitting here. And how much time you allow me?
Sir, as you wish, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. I'll try to keep it short, but still, sir, I have around 36 slides to show. What I'll do is I will go a little fast because this is a valedictory function, and if I had the slot also, I could have then done full justice to the topic which I am talking today right now. And this starts with, let me share my screen with you. Are you able to see my slides?
Sir, visible.
Yes, sir.
Smart materials, is it visible to you?
Yes, sir. Smart materials.
Okay, great. So, this is what I know about the ATEL program. You have taken a good advantage of this by hosting this 5-day program. The vision of this program is really, really very exciting and excellent. It talks about access, equity, and quality of faculty members. And this can be realized only when we also take a pledge with ourselves. We'll try and follow the philosophy of these 3 points which are stated in the vision of this program. This topic, novel materials, is very short in writing, but it is much, much bigger than the Pacific Ocean. And I really appreciate the organizers of this FDP for selecting this very challenging topic, where you come across various terms, terminology, and the technologies involved. And a 5-day program, in fact, is not enough to do justice with this topic. I hope that you will organize few more programs like phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 on this topic, such that the objective of this Atal Yojana and your effort succeeds in motivating few of the colleagues who have attended this program. And I do not know whether there are people from industry, but research scholars are definitely there. So this will definitely give them some new ideas, and all those research scholars who are in the starting stage will be able to remodel or redefine their research activities. This is, I've gone through the brochure, which is beautifully made. It's a very detailed brochure which is prepared. And I was also going through the objective of this FDP printed on the brochure, which says that enrich the knowledge of participants in the emerging areas. So this is commendable. And enrichment of the knowledge of the participants is definitely commendable. And with these skills, participants will be able to find out solutions of industry academic problems. This definitely is something which where I'm little not very optimistic, because identifying problems, industry academic problems, would have been there if you had allowed the people from industry to attend this program. And during this program, there could have been a lot of fruitful interaction with the industry people. And then the researchers working with the various research institutes would have come forward to solve the problems faced currently by the industry. So I hope that this point should be noted by the organizers and try and include the industry people, such that they also feel confident interacting with the faculty members. Right now, the bridge is missing, and our prime job is to create a bridge between the academia and the industry. So we should take advantage of such programs in future. The program will pave the way, pave the path to provide the knowledge for carrying out research in the various fields of engineering based on novel materials for fulfilling the demand of fast development of any country. This technically is very right, but compressing too much within a short span of time, this definitely is required, and we need to produce and experiment with a lot of existing novel materials. And the greatest thing would be if we also contribute some novel materials from our laboratories. And I hope it's not too much to ask for. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So the brief background, because materials or smart materials, intelligent materials, novel materials, these reactive materials, responsive materials, there's so many terms used by the engineers and the researchers today that a starting or a person who is initiating research may get completely confused with this terminology. So I would like to clarify these issues. But let me make the audience comfortable that talking about the materials or smart materials is something which is not new. It has evolved with the evolvement of the human race. And if you can remember your, say, history books or the initial education, school education, you must be remembering still the name of Stone Age, the Copper Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age, then Industrial Revolution 1, Industrial Revolution 2. So these revolutions have taken place just because the mankind learned to use newer materials, and the newer materials keep giving edge to the performance or objective of the human beings. So I'll just jump over. So this development from Stone Age to the industrial present day time, this became possible with an expanding and increasingly intricate and complex use of materials. So it's not that we were not having materials, but in the initial stage or during the industrial revolution, we were probably working with 20 materials or so. Today we are using almost all 92 materials in the from the periodic table. It's a huge jump from 20 materials to 92 materials, and handling all kinds of materials, you are aware of the properties and the function of various elements on the periodic table. So, but you will be like enjoying this feeling that you have tamed these elements to your advantage. So human ingenuity has turned these materials into simple clothes, tools, weapons, and shelters. This is what we have evolved with time. So this, I think I can skip. This material progress has not been a linear advance, but has consisted of two unequal periods. First was a very slow rise that extended from prehistory to the beginnings of rapid economic modernization, that is, until the 18th century in most of Europe, until the 19th century in the USA, Canada, and Japan, and until the latter half of the 20th century in Latin America, the Middle East, and China. Now, the term smart and intelligent materials, what is the concept? We keep talking about these terms in today's time. And what I've observed that at some stage, some people are still little confused, not very clear about the smart materials and the industrial materials which are used. Sorry. Generally speaking, smart and intelligent materials are similar. Materials which can adapt and change because of some kind of external stimuli are called smart materials. But if we consider the analogous concept in psychiatry, intelligence is the attribute we are born with and cannot be altered much, while smartness is something which we acquire by studying, etc. Thus, keeping that as a reference, we might say intelligent materials are those whose innate nature is such that they can adapt and or react according to the external stimuli, while smart materials are especially modified materials that react to external stimuli. So these are some of the other, say, terms which are used for referring to smart materials or intelligent materials. So since they react to any stimuli outside external signals, there are some people use the term responsive, some scientists use the term active, and some scientists use the term which they say is more practically justified, that is the reactive materials, because they react according to our wish, or they react as they are designed for. You can quickly go through this slide. Some of the examples of this smart materials: photochromic pigments, you are very much aware of this in the our spectacles or in the goggles which we use these days, they change color depending on the intensity of light in the system. Then sportswear, which have a facility to ventilate as and when required. Buildings that adapt to atmospheric conditions such as wind, heat, or rain. Drugs that are released into the bloodstream as soon as viral infection is detected. Thermochromic pigments change color at specific temperatures. Examples include color-changing novelty mugs, color-changing spoons, battery power indicators, and fluorescent thermometers. So at least I'm sure that in today's time, most of us are using the novelty mugs which change color when you pour hot liquid in them, and they keep coming back to the original color as they lose temperature. Hydrogels can absorb up to 1,000 times their own volume in water. After this water has been absorbed, it can be released when its surroundings are dry. A hydrogel is a network of polymer chains with great water absorbance ability. Types of soft materials. We are all aware of the materials. We talk about piezoelectric materials. They convert mechanical energy into electrical energy and vice versa. For example, they change their shape in response to an electrical impulse or produce an electrical charge in response to an applied mechanical stress. Lead zirconate titanate, also known as PZT, currently the most powerful and functional piezoelectric material. Sorry. Shape memorialized or materials, they have the ability to change the shape, even returning to their original shape when exposed to a heat source. Chromoactive materials, they change color when subjected to a certain variation in temperature. These examples I've already mentioned. Magnetorheological materials, they change their properties when exposed to a magnetic field. For example, they are currently used in a shock absorbers to prevent seismic vibrations in bridges and skyscrapers. This is a wonderful use and wonderful advantage obtained from magnetorheological materials. Then photoactive materials, there are several types. Electroluminescence, they emit light when they are fed with electrical impulses. Fluorescents reflect light with greater intensity, and phosphorescents are able to emit light after the initial source has ceased. This everybody observes every day on the road signs when the floodlight of the car falls on the signboards. They shine as well as you can read, but once you switch off your light, you can still read for some time. Stress, interesting materials that could shape the future. Examples and applications of smart materials. So I will be introducing some of the real smart materials which have revolutionized our industry and the research labs. Their end use are beyond our imagination in many of the cases. I'm sure some of the names are known to us already, but let me try and say project some names which are worth mentioning or repeating at this stage? Synthetic spider web. This material is not only 5 times stronger than steel, but also has great elasticity. Its potential uses include bulletproof clothing, artificial skin for burns, or waterproof adhesives. So you can see this advantage of this kind of, say, development. Bulletproof clothing is a boon to the soldiers. Artificial skin for your beautification or for burn injuries or for whatever the requirement is. Shrilk. Its main component is chitin, a carbohydrate found in a krill shell. Krill is a small fish type, say, creature found in the seas, and this particular protein is taken out from the shell of this fish, which is known as shrilk. It was created by researchers from Harvard University and is considered the ideal substitute for plastic, since its decomposition time is only 2 weeks, and it also works as a stimulant for plant growth. Now you can imagine what wonders our researcher colleagues have done from the University of Harvard. If we can replace plastic today, you all know that how badly the plastic have destroyed our ecology and our environment. And if we can use commercially some substitute having the same properties, but which decays automatically within 2 weeks. So I think this is definitely a material where our future is dependent on. At least the next generation will survive only when we stop using the present day plastic formulation. Graphene. This name, I think, has become very common these days, but it is a wonder material. Its potential uses are almost unlimited. Batteries with more autonomy, cheaper photovoltaic solar cells, faster computers, flexible electronic devices, more resistant buildings, bionic limbs, etc. All this is possible thanks to their multiple properties. Now, what is graphene? Since it is very commonly used and a lot many people take the name of this wonder material, graphene is one atom thick sheet of carbon atoms arranged in a honeycomb like pattern. Graphene is considered to be the world's thinnest, strongest, and most conductive material of both electricity and heat. All of these properties are exciting researchers and business around the world. So these properties have already excited the researchers and the businesses around the world. And considering the advantage which I written here, we should also, I think there are already a number of people who are working using graphene, and they will be probably able to find more characteristics and properties where graphene can be used. Very quickly, you can read some of the very major properties of this material. I hope you are able to read this. Is it readable?
Yes, sir.
With so many properties and strength, this definitely is a wonder material. But there is a very serious word of caution while planning to use this material for your research. And this word of caution is which will make you scary of thinking about this process, this material? How harmful is graphene? A word of caution. In short, the microparticles of graphene have the potential to cause severe inflammation within the lungs, leading to acute respiratory problems. Eventually, the graphene platelet lost within the lung can also develop a tumor, causing lung cancer. Graphene nanoparticles can prove dangerous for water resources too. Now, on one hand, you have one of the greatest advantages of using this material. On the other hand, the user is finding difficult to survive, because this microparticle or nanoparticle, it is very, very difficult to exclude from your breath. When you are breathing, I do not know how to exclude this particular particle going into lungs, and this is very scary. So anybody who has access to graphene should think twice before opening the bottle of it. Do not try and smell it, otherwise the medical problems are very, very severe, and lung cancer means impossible to survive. So please be careful, and this precaution or safety is not only to be taken with graphene, but with all the modern day smart materials, because when you play with the nature, these materials are not natural. They are man-made materials, and it is very natural to understand that when you are playing with nature, nature also has the right to play with you. If you play with nature, let us say on the scale of 100, you have playing up to a level of 10, the nature will play at the level of 100 with you. So it is very, very difficult to safeguard yourself while trying to play with the materials. It is like, you know, when you play with the radioactive materials, or when you play with the uranium-235 or so. Enrichment is done in an artificial manner. Nature has not given you that enrichment, but we do enrich the uranium-235, and then what havoc it has. If it explodes, you can imagine that what will happen. Metamaterials, they are manufactured in the laboratory with unusual physical properties not found in nature, and are the subject of research in fields such as the military, optics, or telephony. They can, for example, bend electromagnetic waves of light, creating negative refractive indices. XPL, it is a silicon-based polymer that adheres to the dermis like a second skin, created by scientists at the MIT, USA. It replicates the appearance of young, healthy skin by rejuvenating the look of the wearer. So, अभी हमारे वो जो हीरो हैं तमिल सिनेमा के, what is his name? The most popular hero, can you help me by
Rajinikanth, sir?
Rajinikanth. So Rajinikanth, if he comes across this material XPL, he won't be requiring his person who will give him a young look. This skin will present to you as if he is a 20-year-old young boy. Aerogel, this is really a wonder material. In case, like, you know, you need a thermal protection, you need the total insulation, like we use thermos flask, etc., for keeping our the cold or hot objects in that condition. But with time, they also lose their properties. But imagine if you make thermos out of this material, which is known as aerogel. Aerogel is pretty amazing stuff and actually holds records in the Guinness Book of World Records. It is a synthetic porous ultra-light material. Microporous silica, microporous glass, and zeolites are common examples of aerogels. It's also sometimes referred to as a frozen smoke, solid air, solid cloud, and blue smoke. This material is made up of supercritical dried liquid gel of alumina, chromia, tin oxide, or carbon. Aerogel is 99.8% empty space, making it semi-transparent. Aerogel is a great insulator. For instance, you can lay crayons on a piece of aerogel and heat from below with a blowtorch. Guess what? The crayons will not melt. I have included a diagram for this only, aerogel, and it is the small piece of aerogel on which the wax flower is kept, and from below, a very high temperature blow torch is used for heating it, and even after a lot of time has been spent, this wax flower is not melting or it will not melt. So this kind of insulating material, if we have, say, developed in the laboratories, is definitely going to revolutionize our life and our activities. If you have thermos made of this material, do you think the ice or the ice cream will ever melt in this? It will remain solid for I don't know how many hours or days. Carbon nanotubes, this I think everyone knows, very commonly used term. Carbon nanotubes are long chains of carbon held together with bonds that are stronger than the bonds in diamonds. These remarkable structures have countless amazing properties. These include ballistic electron transport, great for electronics, as very high tensile strength, making them a candidate for potential applications such as space elevators. I hope that some of you have come across the term which is known as space elevators. Have you heard this word before, space elevators?
Sir.
Hello?
No, sir.
This is the some scientist. This is still the visualization of our scientist. They expect that it is possible to make an elevator to go to the space instead of using the rockets, instead of using the space shuttles, etc. They are thinking if a space elevator is made, then no rocket or space shuttle, etc., will be required. And lot many people will be able to visit or go to space and come back using these elevators. So this is the vision of a scientist. So you should also think so big, and I'm sure that one day we will definitely have the space elevators as a reality, because we have now the materials which can be used to create safe environment and lightweight, where the mass can be taken care of or the effect of gravity can be neutralized to a great extent. So just a comparison with steel, carbon nanotubes have a specific strength of up to 48,000 kilonewton meter per kg. So this, in fact, is 300 times stronger than steel. Amorphous metal or metallic glasses are basically metal with a disordered atomic structure. They can be up to twice the strength of steel. Owing to their structure, they can disperse impact energy very effectively, even more so than metal crystal. These materials are formed by quickly cooling molten metal before it has had time to align its crystal structure. That is, you created an artificial situation where the atoms and molecules, they tried on kisi aadmi ko jinda hi freezer mein dal diye, liquid nitrogen mein dal dijiye. This is what happens. Person won't be able to say anything the moment he is dipped into liquid nitrogen. The same thing, molten material or metal is simply poured into a tank where it doesn't get time to align or develop as a crystal structure. Metal foam, this is another very promising smart material. I think I've come across some PhD thesis also where people are working on metal foams. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
But you know the difference between the metal foam and the porous materials. There is a confusion with our researchers. What I've seen is most of them are working in creating the porous material, but they end up calling it a foam. Foam is a closed cell structure and porous material is an open cell structure. So creating a metal foam is very interesting. In fact, I have guided one PhD on the metal foam. It is successfully done. And we have produced a lot of metal foam in our lab when I was working with IIT Delhi. And I will suggest this is a very active area where country really needs a very strong technology, commercial technology, where metallic foams are produced. And you can, some research scholars or some faculty members sitting here can definitely note it down somewhere that it is not a very challenging task. You know, conventional aluminium can be converted into a aluminium foam without any environmental problems, without any side effects, without any risk to the health or risk to the lungs, etc., etc. So this is the easiest material or research activity which can be picked up from this program. And just see, owing to its high strength to weight ratio, metal foams have been proposed as potential construction materials for space colonies. You are aware that some countries, particularly USA, China, and India, they have a plan to set colonies on Moon, colonies on Mars and other planets. And for doing so, you have to transport material from the Earth right now at present. And if you have a material which is having almost 97%, say, of it is having the pores within its size, you can imagine that how light it is and how comfortable it will be to create space colonies using this light material. some of these metal foams can actually float in water, which could mean they would have application for floating cities. Now, when you feel that you are short of land, land can be spared for doing farming or producing the food material, and you can shift to the floating cities, which will be structured on the metallic foams, the technology of which will be created by you. You will feel so comfortable and happy that the technology which you developed in your laboratory is used for creating floating cities or creating the space cities or speed colonies. Transparent alumina. It is around 3 times stronger than steel, plus it's transparent. This leads to a number of potential applications for this material. You could clad an entire skyscraper with it. Future skylines would look like a series of floating black dots for private rooms rather than the monoliths of today. Its great strength could also mean it has applications as bulletproof glass. E-textiles. Future clothing may not just be dictated by the fickle nature of fashion. They may well have integrated electronic textiles. Why carry a device when you can wear it? Your mobile phones or whatever the instrument you want to carry with you, there is no point carrying it. You can wear it along with your textile, which you are using, or clothes which you are wearing. You could even project videos of choosing onto your clothing. Made us think of the Teletubbies. Making a video call through your wrist or palm, if you are wearing e-textile gloves, we may be able to integrate thought-to-speech interfaces with these textiles. The possibilities are nearly limitless. So this is another very promising smart materials, where you can say use it for communication, use it for projection, use it for receiving. So everything is really possible with whatever the clothes you are wearing. Molecular super glue. Have you ever experienced the painful, often frustrating phenomena of sticking your fingers together with traditional super glue? Like, I think some of you must have experienced the problem using that Fevikwik, which is super glue and solidifies in minute or so. But if you hand, your hands are or fingers are together, then you have very, very tough time or difficult time separating them. So, but can you imagine one that bonds at the molecular level? Researchers at the University of Oxford have managed to create just such a glue, a solution inspired by nothing less than a Streptococcus pyogenes, the flesh-eating bacteria. So these are some of the very challenging and presently used smart materials by the mankind. This list is far from exhaustive. There are many more in the list, but I've only refreshed the most commonly used or the materials which have a very, very great promise in the future to come. And the promise for a lot of our say, faculty members to change even the direction of research and switch over to the fundamental material development or smart material development, or bringing out the new applications for these materials. Research means it could be like developing the material itself. It could be finding the new application for the material, which can revolutionize your living or your needs, whether they are military, space, or the civil needs. So this is a time you are aware of the fifth generation fighter aircraft, sixth generation fighter aircraft. So these are possible, and the race is for the smart materials, which are very, very light, which are stronger than steel, and also have a property of absorbing or reflecting back, not reflecting back, absorbing the radar detection. So these kind of properties are required. So this is a time DRDO and the government of India is working very actively in producing newer and newer type of weapons, materials, bulletproof jackets, bulletproof helmets are required for our, say, defense people, for the people who control the rights, etc. So instead of buying it from abroad, why can't we feel more satisfied when we see that we have developed a technology for producing the, honestly, the bulletproof jacket, bulletproof helmet, etc. So one slide on the topic of your seminar, because you have titled as novel materials, but this is something which I think is important for everyone to understand the meaning of novel material. Please read it yourself. Public domain materials are not novel materials unless a public domain material is modified in the research program so as to become a novel material. So like there are scientists in the University of Cambridge in UK who has successfully produced invisible steel. Can you visualize that steel structure is there and you cannot see it? He has produced a steel with a helical structure, while otherwise we know that steel only has the BCC structure. But he has changed the structure of the steel itself. So you can imagine that playing with the nature of the material at the atomic or molecular level, you can do wonders and come up with maybe accidentally some new material, because research is always, majority cases, it is accidental. If you had known before that what will happen, then it is not research. So I think go back to your, say, workplaces with this idea that you will definitely try and play with the basic behavior of some of the public domain materials, because you do not need to invest more money, and start playing with it, melt it, pour it in a, like ice cold water, pour it in a nitrogen liquid nitrogen, and study the properties. So you can play with these materials, and maybe when you are studying the properties of your, say, play which you have played in your, say, lab, you may accidentally come out with some revolutionary property or behavior of that material. So I would very strongly suggest that after studying the possible risk of playing with the materials, you must start playing with it and get some Indian name registered internationally. Like we have read the name of University of Cambridge, Harvard, MIT. So maybe Ajay Kumar Garg College of Engineering can also be made famous by the faculty members who are serving it. and they can make it an institute which should become, may become a benchmark for research activities. And it is very much possible. It is not that I am talking something in the air. It is possible. Remember always that scientists make research laboratories. Laboratories do not produce scientists. Remember this always. So it is your thinking process. I think I have no more say further to present. I can say switch over to.
Thank you, sir. Thank you
let me talk to you using my camera. This is I should have taken care of this because so we must take advantage of this webinar. It is a good lead given by this Ajay Kumar Garg Institute, and if not others, but the faculty of Ajay Kumar Garg should accept this challenge that they will come out with some smart or novel material after getting motivated from this webinar. So this is what I had to share with the esteemed delegates sitting here. And thank you very much for giving me the opportunity of sharing the dais with the delegates here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your word of wisdoms. Now I would like to request Dr. Devan Singh, HOD ME, to hand over a memento to our chief guest as a token of gratitude to give him us his valuable time for this validity session.
Sir, it's my great privilege and I'm honored.
Sir, I'm
very grateful to accept my invitation at a very short notice. Sir, I'm very grateful to you, sir. And I also hope to be collaborate with you, sir, for future work and future research, sir, at our institute. And definitely we will. This is the condition of this unseen situation of COVID. So this is virtual, but one day me and Dr. Namrata Gangal will come to your residence, sir, and we will hand over this memento to you in person, sir. Physically, we will hand over this memento to you.
Sir, you are most welcome.
Sir.
It will be a pleasure having you at my residence.
Sir.
And hearing the word that we can collaborate or say we can work together,
sir, definitely
will be a pleasure. And having wonderful facilities,
sir,
in a research area which belongs to my super specialty area, we can do a lot of work and we can think of producing new materials definitely.
Sir,
let us play in your laboratory.
Sir, definitely we will do. We will do.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Great. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir. We have honored to have you with us and we'll look forward to hear you in the near future also. Thank you, sir. Now
you.
I would like take privilege to welcome Dr. Namrata Gangal, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department and Associate Dean R&D AKGEC. And this co-coordinator of this Atal FDP to present the vote of thanks. She is the backbone of this FDP, and due to his continuous effort, we can make success of this FDP. So now I give in invite to Dr. Namrata Gangal. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Nirmal sir. Thank you for your kind words. So I, Dr. Namrata Gangal, consider it a great privilege to propose vote of thanks to all present in the session and who have witnessed this FDP, much needed and inspiring. So first of all, I wish to thank our chief guest of the day, Professor Sunil Pandey, who spared time from his busy schedule to grace the occasion. And today we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts and your lecture on materials in which you have covered almost all the novel materials, and your encouragement This will surely be going to encourage us in our future events. So Pandit sir, you are really a source of great source of motivation for millions of students and faculty members. And our first gratitude is due to you for your unparalleled inspirational words by which you have ignited many hopes of motivation in all of us. On behalf of AKGEC, we extend our gratitude to you. And
thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. And I take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks to our Director General, Dr. R.K. Agarwal, sir. I express my deep gratitude to our Head of Department and Coordinator of this FPP, Dr. Devendra Singh, sir. And I also wish to thank the organizing committee, including Professor Pallav Vishwas, Mr. Vivek Kumar Pansari, Dr. Suman, Mr. Nirmal Garg, Dr. Alok Vardhan, Dr. Vishwas Grover, Dr. Tarun, and all other members who have worked hard to make this FPP successful. And last but not the least, I wish to thank all the participants of the FPP, because without your active participation and enthusiasm, this program was not a success. So thank you. Jai Hind. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Singh sir.
नमस्कार सर. नमस्कार सर.
अरे मिलेंगे, बहुत जल्दी मिलेंगे
सर. सर बिल्कुल सर, बिल्कुल मिलेंगे.
ओके, बाय बाय
सर. बाय बाय.
बाय बाय. गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल.
थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर नमन सर. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू एवरीवन हु पार्टिसिपेटेड. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक्स निर्मल.
सो विद दिस वी आर एंडिंग दिस एफटीपी.
Number the last possible.